Hello students, here I am coming with the second part of my video lecture, that was biosafety and bioethics. In this part we will discuss some examples of biosafety measures taken during epidemic and pandemic, that includes SARS, MERS and latest COVID-19. First we discuss what was SARS. SARS was severe acute respiratory syndrome, that was a viral respiratory illness caused by the SARS associated coronavirus. It was considered first emerged into 21st century, and it was emerged in Asia in February 2003. It was spread in North America, South America, Europe and Asia. It was a first selected agent declared that has been the potential to pose a severe threat to public health and safety. SARS is spread by close person-to-person contact and must readily by respiratory droplets. The symptoms of the disease include high fever, headache and body aches, sometimes diarrhea and pneumonia also. The severe cases often evolve rapidly in respiratory distress and require intensive care. The second one was MERS-CoV virus. It was Middle East respiratory syndrome virus, respiratory disease caused by a novel coronavirus that was first identified in Saudi Arabia in 2012. The MERS symptoms include fever, cough, shortness of breath, occasional pneumonia, gastrointestinal symptoms including diarrhea. It was a zoonotic virus which transmitted between animals and people. Studied has also shown that humans were infected through indirect or direct contact with infected dromedary camels. MERS-CoV virus outbreak was identified in several countries in Middle East, South Africa, South Asia, with largest outbreak seen in Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates and the Republic of Korea. The laboratory biosafety guidelines for SARS and MERS-CoV virus that was included: first, handling of specimens. The respiratory and stool specimens, unfixed lung tissue, viral cultures and other laboratory performing diagnostic tests should be done under biosafety cabinet 2 and under biosafety level 2 work practices. Any procedure with the potential to generate fine particulate aerosols, that is vertexing or sonicating the specimens, and physical containment devices, that is centrifuge, buckets or sealed rotors, should be operated under biosafety level 2. Aliquoting, diluting specimens, performing diagnostic tests that do not involve propagation of viral agent in vitro or in vivo, and preparation, heat fixing and smears for the microscopic slides should also be done under BSL-2 practice. The acceptable methods for respiratory protection includes proper fit tests, NOISH approved filters, that is N95 or higher level of filter, powered air purifying respirator, that is called as PAPR, with equipped with HEPA filters with accurate fit testing. The person with limitation should wear loose fitting hoods or helmeted PAPRs. The effective and timely communication should be done between clinical and laboratory staff is to be communicated necessarily timely to minimize the risk incurred in handling specimens for patients with possible infections. Such specimens should be labeled accordingly and the laboratory should be altered to ensure proper specimen handling. The laboratory activities include propagation of virus in cell cultures that must be performed in a BSL-3 facility using BSL-3 work practices. Initial characterization of viral agents recovered in culture should also be done under BSL-3 facility. Public awareness includes this important in managing the spread of disease includes increased attention to hygiene and avoiding crowds. Awareness also support rapid identification, treatment of new cases and facilities collective responses. WHO has been confirmed its responsibility to take on a strong coordinating role in leading the fight against the disease. All countries are urged to report case promptly and transparently and to provide information requested by WHO that could help to prevent international spread. Now coming to this recently, what we are observing during these days, that is COVID-19. It's a pneumonia disease. Initially, it was detected in Wuhan, China, during the December 2019. On February 2020, WHO announced its name as COVID-19. The first symptoms were reported on December 2019, but there was no solid evidence of human-to-human transmission. The virus that causes COVID-19 is mainly transmitted through droplets generated when an infected person coughs, sneezes, and exhales. The droplets are too heavy to hang in the air and quickly fall on the floors and surfaces. The laboratory guideline issued by WHO during March 2020 related to the coronavirus COVID-19. First, handling of specimens and laboratory activities includes all procedures must be performed based on risk assessment in strict observance of any relevant protocols. Initial processing of all specimens should be take place in validated biological safety cabinets. Non-propagative diagnostic laboratory work, for example, sequencing, nucleic acid amplification tests should be conducted at a facility using procedures equivalent to biosafety level 2. The propagative work, including viral cultures, isolation and neutralization assays, should be conducted at the containment laboratory in biosafety level 3. Appropriate disinfectants should be used, that is hypochlorite, alcohol, hydrogen peroxide, quaternary ammonium compounds and phenolic compounds for disinfection. Appropriate personal protective equipment, that is called as PPE, should be worn by all laboratory personnel handling these specimens. Patient specimens from suspected or confirmed cases should be transported as UN3373 biological substance category B. Viral cultures or isolated should be transported as category A UN2814 coding with infectious substance and affecting human. Public awareness is issued by WHO time to time, including protecting yourself and other from spread of COVID-19, advice on the safe use of alcohol-based hand sanitizers. WHO issued varying brochures regarding be ready, be supportive and be informed by the disease. We should follow the social distancing, follow home care advices differently for ill peoples, other family members and caretakers. Care must be taken to cope with stress. That's all for this. Thank you very much.